Hey, I'm Ben Bolin with today's question. What makes your arms, legs, and feet fall asleep? You get up out of your seat, all you feel from one foot is this weird, uncomfortable tingling. Or you wake up in the middle of the night and you can't move your arm at all. It's just kind of flopping around behind you. As your body parts wake up, this strange tingling sensation intensifies. So what's going on here? Usually, you'll feel this sensation after you've been putting pressure on part of your body. So sitting on a foot, sleeping on an arm, or something like that. The pressure squeezes the nerve pathways so that the nerves can't transmit electrochemical impulses properly. The nerve impulses carry sensation information from nerve endings in your body to your brain. And they also carry instructions from your brain to parts of your body. This pressure can also squeeze arteries and it stops them from carrying nutrients to body cells. And that's important because without these nutrients, nerve cells may behave abnormally and that can further interfere with communicating bodily sensations. Due to both of these factors, the information transmitted from the body part becomes kind of jumbled. This causes you to feel that weird tingling sensation. So once you do move your foot or stretch your legs or roll off that arm, the nerve impulses will begin to flow properly again. You don't regain feeling right away, however. There's a certain amount of readjustment time before the nerves transmit these impulses correctly again. So this increases the intensity of the tingling, causing those familiar pins and needles sensations. The tingling might be followed by a more uncomfortable sort of burning sensation before your body part finally returns to normal. So this happens because the nerves in your body are made up of separate long nerve cells and they carry different sorts of impulses. These nerve fibers also have different surrounding structures. Some fibers have thicker insulation around them, so they take longer to begin transmitting impulses properly after they've been squeezed. The fibers that transmit pain and temperature information are relatively thin, though, so that's why you feel the tingling sensation pretty quickly. Motor control fibers are thinner than the ones carrying touch information, and that's why you can move the body part before you've regained complete feeling in it. So eventually, all your nerve fibers are going to return to normal, and then you'll regain full use of your sleeping body part. Thanks so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode. If you're feeling charitable, why not like, comment, or subscribe? We'd love to hear some stories about what has happened to your nerve endings, but you know, keep it like PG-13, right? That's it. We'll see you next time.